Could a strange substance found by a Southwest Arkansas man be part of a government test? Well, that's the question at the heart of a phenomenon called chemtrails, now getting widespread attention. Well, tonight, KSLA News 12 investigation reporter Jeff Barrell shows us the results of testing we had done about what's in our skies.
Well, they say the government is dumping chemicals on us to control or manipulate the weather.
And they say the unusual-looking jet trails in the sky are actually chemical-laden chemtrails. It's a belief gaining popularity here in Colorado. So, is there really poison in the sky? Fox 31's Heidi Hammett investigates.
Auf einem Radarschirm auf und waren ganz lange unerklärlich. Mittlerweile deutet alles darauf hin, dass ein Militärexperiment die Wolken verursacht hat. Und jetzt hat ein neues Gebilde offenbar Kurs auf NRW genommen. Was das bedeutet und welche Rolle geheimnisvolle Düppels dabei spielen, Pavis Kosravi verrät es Ihnen.
Well, when was the last time that you watched a jet leave a trail of white overhead and wondered what's in that plume, whether it's something to enjoy or maybe even something to be afraid of?
News 10's Dave Marquis joins us with a look at two very different views.
Poison. Who paints the morning sky?
Lines in the sky.
Brilliant, bright, white plumes.
Strange circles.
What chemicals they use, I do not know.
Peculiar patterns.
And I saw grids and grids, planes flying back and forth.
For thousands of people in Colorado.
I think they're spraying chemicals.
Across the country and around the world.
It's scary. It is very scary.
It is a mile-high mystery.
All of these things change the growing cycles.
Peterson says altering the amount of sunlight that hits the earth will lead to damaged crops, dead and dying trees, and the disappearance of honeybees.
Then I think we're going to be in more trouble than ever before.
So is it a contrail or a conspiracy? No matter who or what you believe, thousands of people are left wondering, looking to the cloudy skies for an answer that is clear. Heidi Hammett, Fox 31 News.
Well, the U.S. military has been known to manipulate the weather in the past. During the Vietnam War, they used cloud seeding to make it rain over supply routes used by the North Vietnamese into South Vietnam.
Barium is a hallmark of other chemtrail testing, which even attracted attention from a Los Angeles TV station. There's already no shortage of unclassified weather modification programs by the government. But those who fear chemtrails could be secret biological or chemical testing on the public point to the 1977 Senate hearings in particular, which confirmed 239 populated areas had been contaminated with biological agents between 1949 and 1969. Later, the 1994 Rockefeller Report concluded hundreds of thousands of military personnel were also subjected to secret biological experiments over the last 60 years. But could secret testing be underway yet again?
I'd rather it be something inert and benign, you know, something that's, you know, not causing any damage, but I'd like to know what it is.
KSLA News 12 discovered chemtrails are even mentioned by name in the initial draft of House Bill 2977 back in 2001 under the Space Preservation Act. But the military denies any such program exists. Jeff Farrell, KSLA News 12 reporting.
As you can tell, definitely two sides to this story, and we've included more in-depth information from both sides on our website. Just go to news10.net, click on the lead story at the top of our homepage. You can find a link to the website California Skywatch and read more about their research into chemtrails. We've also included a link to an explanation from the U.S. Air Force that gives a scientific explanation about why and how chemtrails are formed, or contrails. And please log on to our website on chemtrails. Let us know what you think. We've already got a lot of great responses tonight. We'll use those comments and more tomorrow in our newscast.
Government officials in Russia have been experimenting with cloud seeding for years as a way to manipulate the weather. For example, the mayor of Moscow says the cleanup of heavy snow is too expensive, so he wants to displace winter snow to the surrounding towns. But what are the dangers of trying to control the weather? Joining us now is Bill Nye, the science guy. Bill, first let's start with, what is cloud seeding?
Well, clouds form with water droplets on particles of dust. Without dust or particles of salt blown up from the sea that evaporate off the sea surface, without those dust or salt particles, you wouldn't have clouds and you wouldn't have rain. So the idea is, let's disperse our own particles on top of the clouds, and the rain droplets will form or the snowflakes will form, and then we can control where it rains. But it's a very difficult problem.
Last weather segment. This is inevitably military or something going on. The government, the Air Force, they send out what's known as CHAP, and it's a way to experiment with the radar system. And when you see this kind of a pattern like this, you can rest assured there's something going on. They're actually little bitty magnetic and little bitty strips of, whether it's aluminum, you know, they change it. But what happens is the radar deflects off of all these little pieces, and they use it actually as a jamming mechanism for radar in warfare. But it can also jam our radar and make rain appear that there really is no rain out there.
So you can see scattered showers still showing up on the Pacific Northwest radar throughout the region. The heaviest, of course, well to our north. Here in Southern Oregon and Northern California, we've got a bit of an unusual situation. Now, this first portion of the radar cycle, fairly bland and typical, but then you see these bands of very distinct cloud cover moving into the region. That is not rain. That is not snow. Believe it or not, military aircraft flying through the region is dropping chaff, small bits of aluminum. Sometimes it's made of plastic or even metallicized paper products. But it's used as an anti-radar issue, and obviously they're up there practicing. Now, they won't confirm that, but I was in the Marine Corps for many years, and I'll tell you right now, that's what it is. 50 in Medford right now, 48 in White.
Kampfjäger der Bundeswehr manipulieren unsere Wetterkarten. Diese Vermutung von Bonner Wetterfröschen ist jetzt bestätigt. Unheimliche Geisterwolken mit einer Länge von 350 Kilometern tauchen plötzlich auf den Radarschirmen auf. Allerdings nur auf dem Wetterradar. Einmal im Sommer 2005 und einmal im März 2006. Die Bundeswehr hat mittlerweile zugegeben, dass sie im März eine Luftkampfübung über Holland machte. Für Carsten Brandt von donnerwetter.de ist klar, das ist des Rätsels Lösung.
Wir wissen heute, dass es mit 99,9%iger Sicherheit Düppel waren. Düppel bestehen aus Plastik mit Plastikteilchen, so etwa mit Metalldampf drauf. Die dienen dazu, militärisch Radargeräte zu täuschen. Das ist deren Hauptaufgabe. Und da wurden wohl damals bei der ersten Geisterwolke mindestens hunderte Kilo, wenn nicht Tonnen, ausgesetzt, um so ein riesen künstliches Regenband zu erzeugen.
Conspiracy theorists believe HAARP is responsible for triggering earthquakes in enemy territories like Iran, China, and rogue parts of Afghanistan over the past 3 years. But HAARP's startling potential doesn't end there. Some say it's linked to a strange phenomena occurring in our skies. In recent years, peculiar cloud formations have been appearing in the skies all over the world with increasing frequency.
I think most of us in North America have wondered at these plumes crisscrossing the sky in grid patterns, parallel rows, and the now familiar X's. And many of us have wondered what these trails are.
While highly speculative, some researchers suggest these strange cloud formations are another agent of weather warfare. They first appear to be simply contrails coming from high-flying jet airplanes. But these trails linger in the sky for many hours, some for even an entire day, forming an artificial cloud. Some researchers refer to them as chemtrails.
Chemtrails are deliberately sprayed by high-flying U.S. Air Force tankers, dispersing chemicals into the atmosphere.
Wilt Thomas has authored a book about chemtrails. Since the late 1990s, he has worked closely with another journalist in investigating these strange patterns that appear in the sky.
We have an FAA representative, in fact, a high government official, a person we came to call Deep Sky, attesting to the truth and the reality behind chemtrails. He described this program of spraying chemical trails at high altitudes in so-called commanded airspace, where commercial flights are routed around and beneath tanker airplanes belonging to the U.S. Air Force.
The theory is that chemtrails are being used in conjunction with HAARP. By spraying metal oxides into the air above enemy skies, then directing ELF waves from HAARP to heat those metal oxides, the temperature of the sky is raised to more than 100 degrees Fahrenheit, preventing the accumulation of water vapor that would otherwise form clouds and produce rainfall. The ELF waves HARP produces bounce off the ionosphere and are able to curve around the Earth over the horizon to the ground, making any point on the globe well within reach.
One of the dangers in spreading chemtrails is that it acts as a desiccant and further dries the air. In other words, these chemical particulates can dry up the atmosphere and induce drought.
Imagine the effects of chemtrails on the battlefield, causing extended droughts in enemy countries, drying up their resources, forcing surrender.
When I saw the State of the Black Union, Dick Gregory really moved me and a lot of my friends. I show it to everybody that comes over the house, especially white folks, because they need to hear that, you know, so that they know more about all of us. Mm-hmm. Because what he said affects all of us. He said something that really hit home about this phenomena of chemtrails. And, you know, when I was a kid, I used to see these trails in the sky all the time. And so, oh, that's cool. A jet just went over. And then you started to see a whole bunch of them. And the next thing you know, everybody in your neighborhood was fighting and arguing, and you didn't know why. Okay? And you really didn't know why. I mean, everybody was fighting. So he started riffing about the chemtrails. And he started to say things that hit home so hard. And I would recommend that everybody try to get what he said online or wherever.
And do we do cloud seeding in the U.S.?
Oh, people have tried it. People have tried it for many years.
Hi, Stella. What are you two doing here? Hey.
I think I may know a little something about your poison victim.
And I'm here to prove a man innocent. I got a little intel on Professor Scott. He has a history of espousing various conspiracy theories. Sharing them with the students got him into a little trouble. Every university has at least one unconventional professor.
Oh, come on, Peyton. This guy's ideas here are totally anti-American. Look at this. Water fluoridation, tsunami bombs, chemtrails.
What are chemtrails?
Now, some people believe that vapor exhaust from aircraft are actually dangerous biochemicals dispersed into the air.
Which only proves that Kevin's a little odd.